In this video, I'm going to share with you the 7 best WordPress themes for 2018. If you're not familiar with me, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, and if you want notifications, click on the little bell. Now, this video is kind of going hand in hand with a very popular video that I posted last week, and it was how to choose a WordPress theme, the 7 questions to ask. So this is kind of going along with that. In this video, I prepared the 7 questions to ask to determine if a theme is good or if it's bad. And bad isn't necessarily bad. It just means that it's based on older ways of doing things, older technology. And these 7 questions are geared to help you to decide and determine whether a theme is based on old, outdated technology or modern technologies that will help you get a website built faster, smoother, and you'll actually be able to enjoy the process. Now, to make this convenient for you, I've got links to each of these themes in the video description box down below. Now, let's just get started. The first theme, and in full disclosure, is the theme that I am using on my website that we were just on, is the Astra theme. And you can visit them by going to WPCrafter.com/Astra. And this, I gotta say, one of the things I like about this theme, number one, that it's focused on performance and speed. You don't want a slow website. But one of the nicest things is right here. If you click on starter sites, there is a variety of websites that you can literally restore and start using with just a few mouse clicks. And these are really nice websites. Here, let's take a look at one right here. This doesn't cost you anything, is a beautiful website that can be restored with 3 mouse clicks, and it's a beautiful website for a nonprofit organization, and it even includes integration with donation plugins. So you click on this donate button here in the menu, and it takes you right on over to a fully integrated donation platform. All this was 3 mouse clicks to get this going on your website. So I like a lot of these conveniences. That is the Astra theme. The next one is the Generate Press theme, and they also have this library of websites that you can restore with just a few mouse clicks. I really like that. It's also an theme that is focused on being lean and high performance for you, and they also give you the tools to be able to get a beautiful website up and running with the minimal amount of effort. One of the things I like the most about this theme is the developer. His name's Tom. He is so fast at providing support when you need it, and he is so thorough and invested in those support requests. You know, have you ever needed support from a product developer and they kind of aren't that helpful when they respond? That is not what you get with Generate Press. They are so helpful whenever you ask for help. They are there to help you. Now, the third theme is the Ocean WP theme. And what I appreciate most about this theme is it's the most full-featured free theme for WordPress. In fact, it is the number one theme in the list of popular themes in the WordPress theme directory. It's the number one. Now, there's actually, technically, it's the number 4 most popular theme, but the slots 1, 2, and 3 are the ones that get installed by default with WordPress. So Ocean WP literally is the number one most popular free theme in the WordPress theme directory, no doubt. And it has a strong focus on e-commerce, which is also very nice. Next is the Divi theme. In the last 12 months, the Divi theme has totally changed and made improvements in every nook and cranny, every corner of the theme. It has made phenomenal improvements, and it's been very impressive. Let me show you something that I appreciate about the Divi theme. I'm in the builder right now, and this is part of what they call the Divi Design Initiative. So if I click right here on the plus, and it just pulls up this screen here, this is over 273 page layouts organized in 34 packs. A pack would be an entire website. And when you scroll through here, each of these pages in these packs are, you can restore it by just clicking on a few buttons. So for example, here's for a copywriter. There's one here for a law firm, a SaaS company, interior design company. It's just, they just, the list keeps going on and on. So if I click on this and I say, I like this, I can click on use this layout, and you just have to wait about a minute. It takes it and it puts it right on in there for you, and you can start editing away your new page. And so here we see it's just refreshing the page. That was all it took. Now all I have to do is change some text and change some images, and I'm good to go. So what's nice is it has a inline editor where I can just click and I can start typing, and that's all you literally have to do with this. Now, the Divi theme and the Divi builder, it does have a learning curve. I do find that it's a little steeper of a learning curve initially, but you can get used to it pretty quick. Now you might be asking yourself, wait a second, he's not listing any of those themes on ThemeForce that have crazy amounts of sales and all of that. And I'm not doing that on purpose, because the vast majority of these themes do not meet the requirements that I presented in this video here about the 7 questions to ask. In fact, most of them flat out fail those 7 questions, and they're based on older ways of doing things with WordPress. Now, there's no problem with older ways of doing things. The thing is they usually take a lot longer than modern ways of doing things. And they tend to have a much steeper learning curve. As you're trying to learn how to do what you want to do, it's going to be a bit more complicated. And so that's why those 7 questions are crucial to know before you make a choice of a theme. Now, there are a couple exceptions to the rule, and these are themes where they are more like applications and they solve some kind of higher or bigger purpose. And I'll give you a couple examples of those from some good themes. So I've got 2 here that are directory themes. So that's not your typical website. A directory theme has a ton of additional functionality built into it in order to serve a specific purpose. So a directory theme facilitates listing, having a directory and having these various listings, taking reviews, having this social engagement. I've got 2 for you here. Number 1 is Listing Pro. The Listing Pro is fantastic in the sense that it truly is a single integrated solution for having a directory website, as opposed to this theme right here called MyListing, which is also very good. But this one uses, it's not an all-in-one solution. It pulls in together other plugins to get the full functionality. These 2 are really good. I would give the slightest edge to MyListing because it's not based upon the Visual Composer page builder. Next, and this is a question people have all the time, what is the best newspaper style theme? And you know what? It's called Newspaper. And if, as a matter of fact, I used to use this theme before I switched to Astra. And this is a great theme if you really want that newspaper layout. The only thing about using a very rigid, specific purpose theme like this is some things that you might want to change that don't necessarily make sense, it's not going to be easy to change. A perfect example of that, for me and my website, I wanted all of the images to have that video size image width, right? It's called 16:9 format, but this has all these image sizes and formats that doesn't quite work well with my type of content. So I would have to have all this modified custom code that was difficult to manage. So with a theme like this, you just have to know it is what it is. And if you want to change some core functionality of it, you're looking at custom code and maybe some custom development, but just know that going into it. Now, the last theme might surprise you, and that is Elementor. Now, Elementor is actually a page builder for WordPress, but they recently released version 2 of Elementor Pro, and it is now kind of like a full theme builder. All those parts of a website that were typically only done with your WordPress theme, now you're able to do it with Elementor, and that includes creating headers that look however you want it to look, footers, your archive pages, your blog post styles, every single thing. that you would normally make with a theme and your theme would control it, you can now do this with Elementor. It's amazing everything that you're now able to do with Elementor Pro. It's just beyond impressive, the design flexibility that you have using a tool like Elementor Pro version 2. You can essentially virtually do anything that you could want to do. In fact, this works perfectly with just about every theme that I listed, except the Divi one. It's going to work perfect with all of these themes, and it's really an amazing tool. I use Elementor on my website, on my homepage here, where I've got the scrolling letters. It's all Elementor. All of this for me is all Elementor. It's the page building tool of choice for me that I use on my website. And now you can use Elementor to really build everything out. So that is my list of the best 7 themes for WordPress for 2018. I have links to everything in the video description box. Most of those are referral links. That means if you did click on it and purchase it, a small portion of that goes back to support the channel. It doesn't cost you anything additional. So I've got those links down there. And I want to know what you think about this list. Is there anything that I left out? Add that in the comment section down below. And other than that, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. I'll see you in the next video.